Ozempic, Wegovy tied to lower Alzheimer's risk with type 2 diabetes. GLP-1 drugs like Ozempic may help promote brain health, a new study suggests. In the study, people with obesity who took Ozempic were 71% less likely to develop Alzheimer's. Key takeaway: in a recent study, people with type 2 diabetes who took Ozempic appeared to lower their Alzheimer's risk more than those using insulin. Ozempic was also linked to a greater reduction in Alzheimer's risk compared with metformin and several other older diabetes drugs. Brain health benefits of Ozempic didn't change based on obesity status or gender. Semaglutide, the main ingredient in the injected GLP-1 drugs Ozempic and Wegovy, is associated with a lower risk of Alzheimer's disease in people with type 2 diabetes, a new study suggests. For the new study, researchers examined 3 years of electronic health records for more than 1 million Americans who had type 2 diabetes and no history of Alzheimer's disease. All of the patients had at least one other underlying health condition, such as obesity, high blood pressure, or heart disease, that would make them a good candidate for treatment with semaglutide. They were all prescribed Ozempic or one of 7 older type 2 diabetes medicines, such as insulin or metformin. Overall, people on Ozempic were 41-67% less likely to develop Alzheimer's disease during the study period than individuals taking other type 2 diabetes drugs. While the study wasn't designed to prove whether or how semaglutide might directly reduce the risk of Alzheimer's disease, it's possible that this drug may protect against inflammation and nerve cell damage in the brain that can lead to dementia. In addition, semaglutide treats obesity, type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, smoking, and alcohol drinking, all of which are risk factors for Alzheimer's disease. Semaglutide could reduce the risk of Alzheimer's disease by targeting these modifiable risk factors. Ozempic benefited people with a variety of health conditions. The benefits of semaglutide persisted even when researchers looked at different subgroups of individuals who often have different health outcomes. For example, people with obesity who took Ozempic were 71% less likely to develop Alzheimer's disease, and the risk was 68% lower among those without obesity. Similarly, women on semaglutide were 78% less likely to develop Alzheimer's disease than women taking insulin. The Alzheimer's risk was 52% lower for men. One limitation of the study is that patients were only followed for 3 years, and it's possible that the brain health benefits of semaglutide relative to other type 2 diabetes medicines might look different after longer-term use. Another drawback of the study is that it relied on electronic health records designed for health insurance billing, which may miss some cases of Alzheimer's disease. Researchers lack data from brain scans that are often used to assess whether medications cause changes in the brain that are associated with improvements in cognitive function. Can GLP-1 weight loss drugs prevent Alzheimer's disease? The study also didn't look at tirzepatide, the main ingredient in the GLP-1 drugs Mounjaro and Zepbound. That makes it hard to say whether the effects of Ozempic on the brain might be specific to semaglutide or extend to all GLP-1 medicines. I don't think we know enough yet about the anti-inflammatory properties of GLP-1 medications to say that it is the specific medication class. It would be interesting to see if tirzepatide has similar preventive effects in a large database analysis. There also isn't enough research yet to prove Ozempic or other GLP-1 drugs directly help prevent Alzheimer's disease, making it premature to prescribe these medicines for this purpose. While I could see why some people would consider that, I must emphasize that we cannot give clinical recommendations based on the evidence that is currently available